Hi and welcome. Today you will learn about the displacements in the source engine. So I'll start out here by selecting a texture. You can filter for blend there to get up all these nice blend textures. These are like two textures in one that you can blend between when using displacements. And then you just create a box where you want your displacement. And then you use the texture application tool and select the surface you want to use as your displacement. You go to the displacement tab there and you press create. And now you get to select the power. That's basically the detail of the displacement. So I'm gonna start out with 2, the lowest level of detail. And now I'm gonna go through the tools here. This is the basic paint geometry tool. You just raise and lower the terrain with left and right click. You can also hold shift and drag with left click to pull the terrain like this. It's really easy to use, and yeah, you'll probably figure it out by yourself. Not much explanation really needed here. So next up is the paint alpha tool. This is where the blend texture gets in, because if you chose a blend texture, you will be able to paint the alpha like this between the two textures. The invert alpha button of course inverts the alpha. And then the destroy button makes it back into a brush. The subdivide button isn't really as useful as many of the other tools for everyday use. You have to place two displacements together like this, and then you press the subdivide button to get a smooth transition there. Then we have the noise button. It's used to, well, create noise in the terrain. It's quite simple. And then we have the sew button. This is used to sew together several displacements. So if you have several displacements next to each other, you just select the ones you want to sew together. And then you just press the sew button and they will get sewn together. It has to be perfectly lined up for this to work, of course, and it has to have the same size or exactly half the size of the displacement you want to sew it together with. This is because you want to be able to adjust the power of the displacements by creating several displacements next to each other. So by doing this, you can control the level of detail on the displacements, and you won't have to waste resources and time on getting it perfect where you don't need to have it perfect. So you see, sewing will work even though we have different sized pieces there. And then, yeah, you can change the power there on the fly. When you feel you need to get a bit more detail there. And yeah, that's all there is to it. Rate, subscribe, comment, and send me your tutorial requests. Remember, all my tutorials are based on requests, so if you have any cool requests, don't hesitate to give me a comment or anything. Yeah, bye.